report from the scene. Now here are Mark Howard and Lisa Thomas.
By more people than any other network. ABC.
What is cool? Aruba this summer is cool. Like fresh breeze, like shade trees. Cool like jazz is cool as sailboat, barbecue, dances, scuba too. Aruba this summer, it's one cool summer. Aruba this summer, it's cool. Fly from Philadelphia to Aruba from $579 to $1,019 with Apple Vacations.
Con artists using help wanted ads to help themselves, Tuesday at 11.
Action News, Delaware Valley's leading news program, with Gary Papa, Dave Roberts, and Jim Gardner.
Monday night, crews remove a sign of the times in Oklahoma City, and a DNA expert takes the stand at the O.J. Simpson trial. But the big story in Action News tonight is the murder of police officer Ippolito Gonzalez in Franklin Township, New Jersey. His alleged killers were arraigned in Woodbury today. Charles Staples and Robert Simon were charged with the police officer's murder, and bail has set for each at $2 million. Staples and Simon are members of the infamous Warlocks motorcycle gang. Gonzalez was shot Saturday night during a routine traffic stop on a Gloucester County highway. He was shot no more than 150 yards from the police station. Simon came to court in a wheelchair today. He was shot in the leg while trying to escape. He also happened to have been paroled this year after serving less than his 10 to 20 year sentence for murder. And not surprisingly, there are people wondering tonight how a convicted killer would be paroled before the end of his sentence and just a couple of months later allegedly kill again. Action News reporter Dan Cuella has that part of the story.
The Pennsylvania Board of Probation and Parole is offering no explanation tonight of why it released convicted murderer Robert Simon from prison. But Governor Tom Ridge is said to be very disturbed that this could happen under his watch, and he wants answers.
He was very distressed when he got the report this morning. The notion that you could get out of prison for murder after serving less than 13 years just did not sit right with him.
The governor's office has requested a complete report from the chairman of the Board of Probation and Parole by the end of business tomorrow, even though the panel is an independent agency that does not report to the governor.
Our phone calls seeking comment from the board's chairman, Alan Castor of Philadelphia, were not returned, but we have learned a decision to release Simon was actually made in November, before Governor Ridge took office, but was not carried out until this February.
Simon had a long and violent criminal history with the Warlock motorcycle gang. He served a 5 to 10 year term for robbery. And while in prison, he was charged but not convicted with the murder of a fellow inmate. Later, officials successfully linked him to the 1974 murder of Beth Smith Duesenberg of Drexel Hill. He became eligible for parole in 1992 after satisfying the 10-year minimum for the second-degree murder conviction. The parole board rejected his case 3 times before finally granting parole last November.
It seems to be the same old story regarding the revolving door of justice and the individual being on parole for murder, and it's a set of circumstances that should have never taken place.
Simon is the second person in recent months to be charged with murder soon after leaving a Pennsylvania prison. Authorities say convicted murderer Reginald McFadden went on a crime spree that included rape and murder after he was paroled last summer. That case helped sink the gubernatorial bid of one pardons board member, Lieutenant Governor Mark Single. Now, Governor Ridge wants answers about the Simon case, and he wants them tomorrow. I'm Dan Cuella, Channel 6 Action News.
Philadelphia police have arrested a home health care aide in connection with last night's murder of a 70-year-old woman in Longcrest. 29-year-old Juan Smith was taken in for questioning by police at the scene of the killing today and was arrested and charged tonight with murder and robbery. Nancy Weldy was found stabbed to death inside her home on Weymouth Street last night. Police say Smith had been to the Weldy home on several previous occasions to care for someone else in the house. Lawmen are still trying to determine if a gunman entered the Sony Music building today in Pittman, New Jersey. A police SWAT team and canine dogs converged on the building after several people reported seeing a man with a gun. All employees were told to stay in their offices until police could search the building. No gunman was found, but it was a very tense day for these Sony employees in Pittman. The pace has slowed dramatically at the federal building in Oklahoma City. With the search now over, workers spent part of this day taking down those flags from rescue crews that came to help from all over the country. And workers have been collecting personal items of employees, desk photos, briefcases, purses, and have put them in a trailer at a nearby police station. The items will be returned to the relatives of the victims. Meanwhile, the FBI has denied a report in a Dallas newspaper that investigators have found Timothy McVeigh's Arizona license plate. The report says the plate blew off the car and was found less than a mile from the federal building. The FBI says it has not found the license plate. The O.J. Simpson courtroom took on a feel of a high school biology class today. Here is the latest on the Simpson murder trial in Los Angeles. The prosecution has begun the long process of presenting the DNA evidence it claims can tie Simpson to the murders of his ex-wife Nicole and Ronald Goldman. On the stand today was DNA expert Robin Cotton, the director of Cellmark Labs in Maryland, where the tests were done. Using charts and graphs, she began to explain to the jury what DNA is and how it is different from in each individual. And prosecutor George Clark tried to head off defense claims that the blood samples used to do the tests had degraded too much to be accurate.
So this process of degradation, can it change my DNA into looking like your DNA?
No.
Or your DNA into looking like the court's DNA?
No.
Or any members of the jury or the audience?
No.
At times, the testimony was so dry that it reduced even Simpson to yawns. And ironically, when the trial turned to matters of heredity, Simpson's elderly mother, Eunice, made her first appearance in the courtroom in weeks, sitting in a wheelchair in the front row. Earlier in the day, tow truck driver Bernie DeRue described towing Simpson's Bronco the day after the murders. Under defense questioning, he said he never saw any blood on the vehicle and acknowledged that it was left alone for several minutes once he arrived at police headquarters. Dr. Jack Kevorkian has witnessed another suicide. Kevorkian's lawyer made the announcement today in Michigan. Jeffrey Feiger said that the Reverend John Evans suffered from lung disease and died in a manner consistent with other deaths Kevorkian has attended. This was the first death that Kevorkian has attended since the U.S. Supreme Court refused to hear his appeal. The Michigan Supreme Court ruled in December that there is no constitutional right to assisted suicide. That means Kevorkian can be prosecuted by the state. Well, today is VE Day. It is the 50th anniversary of the end of World War II in Europe. President Clinton, the first president born after the war, led the country's tribute today. He placed a wreath at the Tomb of the Unknowns at Arlington National Cemetery. And later, Clinton enjoyed watching marching military bands at Fort Myer, Virginia. About 2,000 veterans of the Second World War gathered at Fort Myer, and Clinton paid them high tribute.
We come today, 50 years later, to recall their triumph, to remember their sacrifice, and to rededicate ourselves to the ideals for which they fought and for which so many of them died.
Clinton went on to say to the veterans directly, "Because of all you did, we live in a moment of hope and a nation at peace." And they celebrated VE Day all over Europe today, France playing host to the leaders of 80 countries. Leaders from both victorious and defeated nations gathered at the Arc de Triomphe today, where the Nazis humiliated the West by goose-stepping their way through the occupation of Paris. For President Mitterrand, this will be the last starring role on the world stage. Jacques Chirac won the election on Sunday. Vice President Gore and his wife represented the United States, and he, along with other leaders and about 10,000 guests, were awed by a spectacular multicolored flyover by jets right over the Champs-Élysées. Closer to home, Philadelphia area veterans gathered at the Valley Forge Military Academy today, and these veterans played a starring role in the end of the war. They fought in the Battle of the Bulge, the last push that spelled the end of Hitler and Nazi Germany. Today, they remembered their own experiences, and they remembered their friends who died on foreign soil. The city of Philadelphia marked VE Day tonight on the parade grounds at Fort Mifflin. Tonight's ceremony included a parade of state flags carried by sailors from the USS Kennedy and an appropriate musical selection performed by the Sammy Kaye Orchestra. May 8, 1945, a profound day for thousands of veterans from this area and for their families here at home. Tonight, Mark Howard looks back at how it was for the men and women at the front and for their loved ones on the home front.
VE Day was marked with cautious relief by soldiers on the front lines in Europe. American troops were warned that German soldiers might fight despite the fact their government had surrendered. Lieutenant Francis Brown of Chestnut Hill was with General Patton's Third Army in Austria. Brown was finishing this letter to his parents on that day. They were among many thousands hoping to get letters postmarked after the 8th of May.
When they received the letter with a postmarked on it later than the May 8th, that they knew their loved one was still living and would be home soon.
On the Delaware Valley home front, wild celebrations were tempered by somber ceremonies. There was joy, the war in Europe was over, but many people paused to remember those who died and the soldiers who were still fighting in the Pacific. Philadelphia's Mayor Bernard Samuel sounded the city's air raid siren at 9 a.m., officially marking the end of the war in Europe. At a ceremony at noon, the Liberty Bell was tapped in a nationwide radio broadcast. All the major department stores and bars were closed, and people packed the streets of Center City. Philadelphia singer Kitty Callan might have had these Center City scenes in mind when she sang, "It's been a long, long time."
Kiss me once, then kiss me twice, then kiss me once again. It's been a long, long time.
Soldiers were a virtual magnet for people ready to express their joy. These soldiers walked off a train in Center City and walked right into a party.
When we hit the last, step, the pavements up there, all these about 30, 35 girls surrounded us.
Leon Rosen says he was hugged and kissed and had confetti thrown in his face.
But I enjoyed every minute of it.
Most Center City workers spent the day tossing ticker tape and paper out windows. That was the case for Lorraine Shanosk. Lorraine says she doesn't remember being photographed that day because she was caught up in the euphoria.
I think that's a funny picture with all the confetti and everything. That's really something. We were wild that day, really wild.
I remember VE Day as a small boy, the family thrilled to hear that my brother was alive and well and would be coming home from Europe. A lot of families weren't so lucky, though. Their brothers and sons and fathers were preparing for the invasion of Japan. That, of course, is another story we'll save for August. I'm Mark Howard, Channel 6, Action News.
Still to come on Action News tonight, the Flyers try to take a two-game lead in their Stanley Cup playoff with Buffalo. And the mystery over a puma found in an auto repair shop.
The nice weather is about to come to an end. We'll tell you all about it when we check the AccuWeather forecast.
Gary Papa also has the Phillies going for an Atlanta sweep. That and more when Action News continues tonight.
I'm Chris Wallace. Tonight on Nightline, as the world again celebrates the end of World War II, one of its last remaining mysteries is explored. How did Hitler die? First-time look at a secret Soviet archive, the Hitler Files, tonight.
It's happening now, but only until May 27th, and only at your Quality Plus Ford dealer. It's their biggest Ford Escort sellout ever, featuring low 4.9% financing for 48 months or $600 cash back. Take your choice on every Ford Escort in stock. Get 4.9 financing or cash back on every Ford Escort 3-door, every 4-door, every 5-door, every wagon, even every GT. And that's before you get your Quality Plus Ford dealer's best deal, 4.9 financing or $600 back. But hurry, the Ford Escort sellout ends May 27th.
Hello, I'm Monica Melpass.
And I'm Rick Williams. Tomorrow on Action News at 6 a.m., highlights of a second duel between the Flyers and Sabres.
And the CD's newest role in the computer world.
Watch Action News tomorrow at 6 a.m. with Monica Melpass, Rick Williams, and Dave Frankel.
So there's 365 days in a year, 250 of which are working for the rent, about 98 whole days sleeping, another 6 doing things you don't want to for someone else who doesn't appreciate it, 1 day brushing your teeth, 2 days combing your hair, 3 entire days standing in elevators, and 4 days waiting in line at the DMV, which, believe it or not, leaves only 1 measly day to sit back and have a beer. So make it a great tasting one. And since there's not much time left to work out, make it a light. Amstel Light. A light beer. For a heavy world.
It's a summer of power, a summer of excitement. It's Mitsubishi's summer of thunder. The time to enjoy electrifying leases on the 3000 GT. Eclipse. Mirage. With a lease on the Mirage S for $159 a month. During the summer of thunder, from Mitsubishi, the new thinking in automobiles.
Firefighters in Burlington County, New Jersey, have their hands full with an industrial blaze tonight. At least five companies were called to the Conwed Company on Cooperstown Road in Delanco. That after fire broke out inside the plant just after 7 tonight. There have been no reports of any injuries, but at last word, the stubborn and smoky fire was still not under control. The same plant was the scene of another serious fire back in January. Federal agents have indicted three employees of an auto agency on money laundering charges and are warning other companies to watch out. We get details from Action News reporter Karen Friedman.
The sign reads Team Dodge, but until recently, and under different ownership, this car dealership on North Broad Street was called Brandel Dodge. Tonight, Brandel's former top team is in big trouble. In what could be the first in a series of crackdowns, today, the IRS indicted Brandel's former general manager, sales manager, and a consultant for allegedly laundering more than $150,000. Uncle Sam says the three conspired to hide 7 cash sales over $10,000 each. An IRS spokeswoman describes how they were caught.
The undercover agent goes in and identifies himself as a drug dealer who wants to launder some money. And in this case, it was money over $10,000, which needed to be reported on a Form 8300.
Beginning this month, the IRS will start spot checking large businesses that deal in cash purchases. For example, car dealers, boat dealers, furriers, jewelers. About 2 years ago, the IRS started informing these businesses that they had to report these purchases, but they say they didn't penalize anyone. This time, the IRS says it's a lot different.
Our agents go through the bank transactions. They do a lot of matching with other statements, and they do catch them, as you can see by the indictment today.
At Conestoga Nissan in Conshohocken, where cash sales are fairly common, managers know all about Form 8300. But sometimes, knowing what to report can be confusing.
Usually have combinations, and that's really where the problem comes in, is someone, you know, paying with a trade-in and some additional cash on top of the trade-in.
Failure to report cash payments of over $10,000 can result in fines of up to $500,000, as well as jail time. I'm Karen Friedman, Channel 6 Action News.
We would like to stress again that the indictments Karen just talked about concern the former operators of the Dodge dealership on North Broad Street. The current operators of Team Dodge were not part of this investigation, have not been charged with any wrongdoing. Surgeon General nominee Dr. Henry Foster has picked up the support of Senator Arlen Specter. In a speech on the Senate floor today, Specter said he would vote for Foster and that he expected Foster to win confirmation. Specter is the second Republican to endorse Foster. The only Amish school left in Lancaster County will remain open for at least another year. The Penn John School in Loyola have been in danger of closing because of declining enrollment. But tonight, the Conestoga Valley School Board voted to continue to fund the Penn John School through the next school year. They will raise the money by increasing school taxes by about $5 a year for each household.
Your favorite Hollywood stars get moving with me.
Oprah's gonna get moving with me.
Let's get moving!
And how do these stars keep themselves moving? Don't miss this once-in-a-lifetime event. Next Oprah.
Tomorrow at 4, only on Channel 6.
On May 14th, Infiniti will shatter your notions of what a $30,000 luxury car can be.
For cars that can benefit from higher octane, Texaco Clean System 3 Power Plus and Power Premium are formulated to clean your engine's intake valves, fuel injectors, and combustion chambers while you're driving, to give you smooth starts and sure acceleration. Just give us 5 tanks, and we think Power Plus and Power Premium will make quite an impression on you.
Add more life to your car! Take it to the store!
Tell Jim I'm coming home!
Going to the hospital. It's an emergency.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow.
For their comfort, for their skill, for their caring.
U.S. Healthcare salutes all the medical providers who stand by us from the darkest of nights to the brightest of tomorrows. U.S. Healthcare, the health plan for living.
If there's something missing from your $30,000 luxury car, you'll probably find it in ours.
Lindros not playing, so another profile in courage from the Philadelphia Flyers.
Who will step up tonight? How about the story of Game 2 is how the Flyers jumped on top early and how Ron Hextall simply outplayed Dominic Hasek. First, the offense, about 3 minutes to go in the first period. Rod Brind'Amour. Then in the second period, watch this break. And here comes Brind'Amour. There's Rob DeMeyer. Classic two-on-one. Shorthanded that was. But 52 seconds later, Brian Holzinger zings it past Hextall, his only mistake tonight. However, just 1:21 to go in the second period. Finally, the big line gets going against John Muckler's team. Michael Renberg to end to Semenov. Then in the third, it'll be Hextall. It'll be Hextall one more time. He faced 30 shots tonight, and he will stop 29 of those. Oh, my, it's Hextall. Live from the Spectrum, it's Scott Palmer with the story from the locker room, and the story's got to be Ronnie Hextall tonight, Scott.
Gary, it's hard to believe that in some circles there was actually a debate about who should be the starting goaltender for the Flyers in this playoff series against Buffalo. After the game tonight, Dominic Hasek admitted he was outplayed by number 27. This was vintage Ron Hextall.
Things went well. I mean, it's great as a goalie when you got a two-goal lead. You know, it gives you a little bit of comfort, and hey, it's a nice way to win.
Focus pretty much as far as goaltenders, I guess nationwide or North America-wide, was on Hasek in this series, and maybe Ron Hextall was overlooked a little bit. Did you think about that going into this series, Ronnie?
Doesn't bother me one bit. They can talk about and look at whatever they want. We just, I said before the series, it's one hockey team against another. It's not Lindros versus LaFontaine or Hextall versus Hasek.
Well, he was on top of the puck. He seemed to be on the rebounds that were there. He seemed to be right back on top of them. He moved the puck well.
Anatoly Semenov, filling in for the injured Eric Lindros, scored a goal tonight. And now we'll have something to tell his young son, who is still living in California.
Every time when I call back to home, and he asked me, you score? I said, no, because you're not shooting.
He tells you you're not shooting.
Yeah, he's my coach.
The coach turned out to be right. When Anatoly talks to his son tomorrow, he can say, I shot, I scored. Things are going that way for the Flyers as they head to Buffalo, up 2-0 in this series. Right now it's all Flyers. I'm Scott Palmer, Channel 6 Action News, live at the Spectrum.
A little play-by-play from Scott Palmer. Game 3 Wednesday at Buffalo, Game 4 Friday night. Phil Andrews will be shuffling off to Buffalo as we continue our Stanley Cup coverage. How about in Pittsburgh tonight? Penguins down 3-1, but then it's tied at 3, and here comes Kevin Stevens. 5-3 Penguins, series tied. One game apiece, dancing a little bit. How about on the scoreboard? 8-3 Rangers, they tie that series at 1. 3-0 New Jersey, they are up 2-0. Baseball, Phillies going for a 4-game sweep in Atlanta. It could be the first since July of 1973, about 22 years ago. Greg Jeffries starts it off tonight. First inning, his first home run as a Philly. 2-0. Out of here. Want to see an interesting play? A little luck for the Phillies. How about a 5-6-5 putout? How does that work? How does that work? That's how that works. But really out there, David West had nothing. They pulled him after 2 because...
failure to generate arm speed. Translated, he didn't have anything.
Wasn't throwing worth a hoot.
No.
Anyway, Abbott took over. How about defense, Mickey Morandini? For 2. In the 9th, Phillies lead down to 3-2. Heathcliff Slocum versus Fred McGriff, and Heathcliff gets his league-leading 5th save. The Phillies come back for 3 against Montreal tomorrow. Butch Henry versus Paul Quantrill. NBA News, Jerry Stackhouse is leaving North Carolina, and San Antonio has defeated the Lakers in overtime. Exciting tonight in Atlanta, and exciting tonight at the Spectrum.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Monday Night Football took on a new meaning at the Philadelphia Festival of Rural Cinema tonight. As part of the festival, a party was held at the Bourse tonight following the screening of a movie titled NFL Films, The Stylists and Storytellers. Eagles owner Jeffrey Lurie joined other guests in honoring NFL Films president Steve Sable for his organization's 30-year contribution to the art of capturing sport on film.
I work with people that I respect.
Just a word about taking the family to Ocean City.
Please! Ocean City, Maryland. Let yourself go. Call 1-800-OC-OCEAN.
History has proven the Accord to be a sound investment. For a limited time, we're making it sound even better. Save $900 on an option package that includes a Honda 6-disc CD changer and a Honda in-dash cellular phone. But these specially equipped Accord EXs are limited, so see your Honda dealer soon, because if history is any judge, these Accords won't be around very long. Also for a limited time, 2.9% financing on the Accord EX.
Some trendy places may offer a pita sandwich like 7-Eleven's, with juicy ham, turkey, and Swiss cheese layered between two pitas. But can they give you this? The Deli Central Pita Sandwich, delivered fresh every day to 7-Eleven. Like Grandma, 7-Eleven bakes their world oven cinnamon rolls fresh with rich, creamy icing. But Grandma adds a touch we don't.
There, there.
World oven cinnamon rolls, delivered fresh every morning to 7-Eleven.
How have Heckage's low prices affected you?
They've made it possible for a working mom like me to get things done around the house.
Talk about cleaning up. Heckinger has Duron Performance Semi-Gloss Exterior Paint for only $17.97. And get a Black & Decker electric mower for $179, the lowest price in town.
Of course, I don't just use Heckinger for the cleaning. Or meatloaf, anyone?
Heckinger, the low price keeps you coming back.
How old is he?
4. Yours?
6.
He likes the colors.
Yeah, I remember getting Mother's Day cards when mine was that age. Took me forever to put them back.
Yeah.
There are hundreds of Hallmark Mother's Day cards in every CVS. All you have to do is pick one.
Don't worry. Gets better.
It gets better.
Robbie! Come here.
Hey. If you're looking for just the right Hallmark Mother's Day card, CVS has just what you're looking for.
Dave Roberts on the exclusive AccuWeather forecast.
David. Day of sunshine. We're going to have another day of sunshine tomorrow. Later on, a few clouds starting to build, but all in all, a very nice day on the way as we start to lose the high pressure produced today's weather. Nice weekend for us up there in eastern Canada, down here off the Georgia coast. Plenty of sunshine up and down the coast. This is what we are watching. Storm center in the central plains. A warm front out in front of it. Lots of thunderstorm activity, heavier stuff down here, and a cold front behind it. Let's go to action radar. And you'll see the system across the United States. See it building there. Mississippi and Louisiana, hard hit tonight with tornadoes reported down there, heavy thunderstorms. Then the line just builds right up into Illinois, on into Iowa. Of course, these are the same systems that produced storms over the weekend. And this was the scene in Coleman County in Texas. You see this tornado, flash of lightning. Tornado moving through the area, ripped the roof right off of this home and took part of this home too. Lots of damage reported, no loss of life, but those are the heavy storms moving out of this system. We don't expect to get the heavy stuff. We do expect to get some rain out of it, though. First, the warm front coming through with some precipitation, and then the frontal system coming through behind that. It's on the five-day forecast, so the call from AccuWeather is one more nice day. 51 in Allentown, 54 in Redding, Trenton 54. Up in the Poconos, 50 degrees, Wilmington 56. 47 was our low. We hit 70 degrees today. That came at 4:43 this afternoon. Where was the action cam around sunset? There it was, a view of the city. Present temperature reading, 59 degrees. Humidity, 40%. The barometer's on the rise, 30.14. Winds out of the northwest, 12 miles an hour. Ocean water temperature 54 degrees. We'll show 5.2 in the northeast, 5.7 outside the station, 60 for Center City, 5.9 at the airport, and Camden 58. The exclusive AccuWeather 5-day forecast. Few clouds tonight, going to be on the cool side, 38 in the suburbs, 48 for Center City. Sunshine for rush hour in the morning. We start out at 53. We're up to 72. A nice day. Increasing clouds in the afternoon. And late tomorrow night, on into Wednesday, we look for a period of rain with cooler temperatures, high of only 67. And then on Thursday, we're calling for some sun, maybe a little bit of that rain hanging out. Depends on how quickly the system moves. But 74 degrees, 72, partly sunny on Friday. And on Saturday, 76 degrees. We warm up a little bit under partly sunny skies. So a few clouds. One more nice day out of the system before the rain arrives on Wednesday.
Thank you, David. Still to come on Action News tonight, a painting from Picasso's Blue Period goes for lots of green. That and more when we continue in just a moment.
Want to make a Consumer's Digest Best Buy an even better buy? Well, right now, we're offering $1,000 cash back on every Dodge Caravan. Not just some, every one. Add in up to $1,100 in package value discounts, and you can take up to $2,100 off America's best-selling minivan. Or choose 4.9 financing instead. So hurry to the Dodge National Best Buy Sale. Right now, current Chrysler Corporation minivan owners get an additional $500 cash back.
Are you sure you're getting the best rates on your international calls?
Now the difference between MCI and AT&T's best international rates is even greater than ever.
It's here in the MCI Proof of Savings Statement. It shows you how you save no matter where you call. Take India. Those savings could be $15 a month, $180 a year.
To England, save $96 a year.
To Mexico, save $132 a year.
There's no doubt who saves you the most.
And no doubt who you should call. MCI.
Disney's a great vacation destination. So is Australia. But Six Flags Great Adventure is just a hop, skip, and jump away. It's bigger than Disneyland and closer to home, with thrill-a-minute rides like Batman the Ride, fun family rides, great new shows, thrilling events, and Six Flags Wild Safari Animal Park. It's so much fun, you'll jump for joy at Six Flags Great Adventure Theme Park. And right now, hop in with these great savings with coupons from participating Burger King.
If you want to see yourself in an Eagle Vision ESI, you need this free vision exam. Because right now, you can get into a sophisticated Eagle Vision ESI with air conditioning and automatic transmission, power steering and brakes, dual airbags, and AM/FM stereo for just $199 a month. But you'd better act fast, because you won't see a lease rate this low on Eagle Vision for very long. Lease Eagle Vision for $199 a month at your Key States Jeep and Eagle dealer.
Animal control officers in Chicago want to know who brought a really big cat into the city. The cat in question is the 75-pound puma. The animal was discovered over the weekend in an auto repair shop. Employees say that the puma was dropped off there by someone they didn't know. It was in a cage and was described as tired, weak, and dirty. The puma is expected to be turned over to a zoo in the Chicago area. Finally tonight, from a misplaced puma to a pricey Picasso. At Sotheby's Auction House in New York tonight, Picasso's portrait, Angel Fernandez de Soto, went for $29 million. That was three times the estimated value of the 1903 painting, which is also known as the Absinthe Drinker. The buyer was a private collector who asked to remain anonymous. Nightline is next on Channel 6. Action News continues at 6 a.m. with Monica Malpass, Rick Williams, and Dave Frankel. Now for Dave Roberts, Gary Papa, the entire Action News team, I'm Jim Gardner. Have a good night tonight.
During the O.J. Simpson double murder trial is getting a lesson on DNA, the family of victim Nicole Brown is facing Mother's Day without her. On the next day in Philadelphia, a look at Nicole's favorite Mother's Day photos. Plus, what does Nicole's sister Tanya have to say about O.J. and his high-priced lawyers? And how does she think the trial should end? On the next AM Philadelphia.
Tomorrow morning at 10, right after Jenny Jones on Channel 6.
It's happening now, but only until May 27th, and only at your Quality Plus Ford dealer. It's their biggest Ford Escort sellout ever, featuring low 4.9% financing for 48 months or $600 cash back. Take your choice on every Ford Escort in stock. Get 4.9 financing or cash back on every Ford Escort 3-door, every 4-door, every 5-door, every wagon, even every GT. And that's before you get your Quality Plus Ford dealer's best deal, 4.9 financing or $600 back. But hurry, the Ford Escort sellout ends May 27th.
It's Siemens' anniversary, and we're celebrating with a sale so huge, it was 62 years in the making. Every single item in every Siemens showroom, the largest furniture inventory in the Northeast, is a fraction of its original cost. There's no down payment, no interest, and no payments until August. Plus, 62 lucky customers will win a $500 shopping spree. Come save on everything as Siemens celebrates 62 years of comfort and beauty with savings. Siemens Plus.
It's a summer of power, a summer of excitement. It's Mitsubishi's summer of thunder. The time to enjoy electrifying leases on the 3000 GT. Eclipse. Mirage. With a lease on the Mirage S for $159 a month. During the summer of thunder. From Mitsubishi, the new thinking in automobiles.
Perry King and Joan Van Ark tonight after Nightline.
May 8th, 1995.
Today, the world celebrates again the end of World War II and the end of the man who caused it. But how did Hitler die? It's one of the mysteries that's never been solved. Was this his corpse or that of a look-alike? Did he die from a gunshot or poison? What really went on in those final moments?
Linge pushed me aside and ran to the door. He saw that Hitler was dead.
Tonight, the Hitler Files. A first look at the answers in a secret Soviet archive.
This is ABC News Nightline. Substituting for Ted Koppel and reporting from Washington, Chris Wallace.
Around the world today, they were celebrating a great moment in Western history, VE Day, Victory in Europe. President Clinton laid a wreath at Arlington National Cemetery. In London, the royal family joined tens of thousands of people singing songs from World War II. In Berlin, German leaders acknowledged their nation's responsibility. But as we honor those who fought and won the war,